Hi, in this video I want to talk about Cubase file management, meaning the audio files that you record, where does Cubase put them, how can you solve problems if they've ended up all over your hard disk, what's the way to clean them up, and how can you move projects safely. So lots of practical things when you work with Cubase and its audio files. So let's go! So I'm making this video in response to a question that the drummer of my band The Wash had in one of our recent rehearsals, which was about audio file location when using Cubase. Somehow he had gotten it messed up, and it wasn't working anymore in the way he expected it to work. So I figured I'd make a little video about it, because some of you may have the same questions and may run into the same problems if you're not careful with what you're doing. Although the default way that all of this works in Cubase should prevent you from getting into trouble, but yeah, there are a couple of situations which are a bit icky, so let's have a look. So over here you see part of my desktop with Cubase at the top, and let's start a new project. Now when you start a new project, Cubase usually opens up with the Steinberg hub, and on the bottom right side you're seeing the controls for where the new project will be created. So I must say that I usually have it set to prompt for project location, so that I can exactly choose where the project will be stored. Although all of my Cubase projects are under eCubase data, they are not directly under eCubase data. So they may be in subfolders, like there may be a subfolder for a wash and another subfolder for albums of a wash. And then under the album folder, I may have a subfolder for song, for example. But if you are someone who always puts his individual projects under the main folder, you can basically use the use default location, because that means that the new project will be created under the location which is set here, and over here you can just type the title of your project in. Now if you want to change the default location that Cubase puts projects in, when you use this option, you can click over here and you see that you have the ability to select another default location. But like I said, I always use this option, so I'm going for that. I'm saying create empty project, and now basically I get the option to select in which folder I want to add my project. So I'm going to do this under the main folder for the Cubase file management. And let's assume that I want to create a project for song one. So I'm selecting that one. And what you're seeing over here now is that Cubase has created an empty project. First thing I always do after creating a project, just go to the project setup and I make sure that my sample rate and my bit depth is set to what I want to use. And these are my default settings, actually 24 bit, 48 kilohertz. So this is okay. Okay, and the second thing I do is actually saving the project for the first time. So if you click save, Cubase will prompt you for a name of the project file, which, well, it seems logical to also call that song one. And if you now look in the folder structure that we created, you see I have my song one folder, and in there is an audio folder and the song one project file. Now in the audio folder, there's nothing there yet because I haven't recorded anything yet. So let's record something, add an audio channel, a mono channel, let's call it voice. And let's arm it for recording and start to record from the beginning. I'm just recording my voice now, nothing fancy, and that should be enough. So in the info line, you can see that Cubase created a file called voice_1, which is basically, yeah, the name of the track. And the 01 is the take, because you can do multiple takes. Let's do a second take for this track. Let's record it. Let's start recording. This is take 2. For the voice recording, nothing fancy again. Stop. And you see that I have 2 lanes with 2 takes for the same track, both called voice, and they have the number of the take. Now, if you now go to the folder structure, you can see the main project directory still contains the audio folder, but it has also created images and track pictures. There's nothing in track pictures, but the images are basically, yeah, the waveforms that are displayed in here. Cubase stores them, so it doesn't have to recalculate them all the time. Now in the audio folder, you have the 2 takes that I just did. and you actually see that there's a preparation file for the third take, which I'm not going to do. So if I close Cubase, this will be removed because there's nothing in it. You can see from the file size that the file is currently still empty. Now, related to audio file management, there's a very nice tool in Cubase, which is called the pool. You can get it by Control P or going Project Pool. And over here, you can see which audio files you have in your project. So right now you see that I have Voice 01 and Voice 02. And over here it says exactly where they are on my hard disk. Now another thing that you can do is bring an already existing audio file into your project. For example, I may want to also have this audio file from another project into my current project. So I just drag it from the file explorer. And Cubase now asks me what to do. So what I definitely want to do is I want to copy this file to my new project folder, because I want this in my Song 1 project folder and not somewhere else on my hard disk in some other projects folder. So if I select this, Cubase will copy the file to my Song 1 audio folder. There we go. Yeah, so this file is quite long, so I'm going to shorten it a bit to line up better with my other audio files. And again, if we now look at the project folder structure, you can see the Song 1 folder with the project file, and in the audio folder, I still have my two real takes, the next take, and the new audio file that I just dragged in, which is a copy of the original location file. So why is it a good idea to have all your project related files under a single folder, called Song 1 in this case? Well, for one thing, it makes backing up a lot easier. So if you now back up the Song 1 project folder, you at least know that you have everything that you need for that song, and you don't have to back up random files in other places on your hard disk. Another reason is that it's way easier to take the project somewhere else now, because you can basically just put this one directory, the Song 1 directory, on a disk drive or a USB stick, or even zip it and send it via WeTransfer to another studio. And on the other side, you can just unzip it, and then you will have all your audio files that you need for that project. And a third reason is that it's way easier to clean up if you always follow this system, because you know that if you clean up this project directory, Song 1 for example, because you may archive it after some time, that you're not damaging any other projects, because every project has its own main folder and audio files are not shared between project folders. Now imagine for some reason you want to move your project folder. For example, you want to move your Song 1 project to another place on your hard disk. Let's have a look. Yeah, let's suppose that I decided that I don't want my Song 1 project directly under the LS20 directory, but that I want Song 1 under an album directory. So I'll first show you the way not to do this, because you might be tempted to go like this. You say File, Save As, you move to your album directory, you say, well, I also want a Song 1 folder under the album, and in there I want to save my project file. So if you now look at your folder structure and you look at what's under the album, so there's again a Song 1 folder, however, only the project files in there. So right now you've created a situation that the project that's open in Cubase is located under album, Song 1. However, the audio files are still here, and you can actually see that in the pool. If you look at the pool again, you see that these are the audio files. They're all directly under Cubase File Management Song 1 audio. And that's not what you want, because that means that the audio files are no longer stored with your project file. So let's revert that. Let's close this one. So let's first get rid of that faulty project. So under album, I'm just going to remove the Song 1 folder with the included project file. And now I'm going to reopen the project in its original location, and luckily that's still working. If I look at the pool, audio files are indeed still in the same location as my Cubase project file. Now, there's two ways to move this project. One is a very safe way, and that's by creating a backup of this project. So you can see, say, backup project. You can move it to the album. And a new song, one directory under album. Select folder. Yeah, you can decide to remove any unused files, but we are using all files, and we're again calling it song one. Backed up so that we can see the difference. And it has done its thing, and Cubase has also opened the new song one in the new location. Because if you look at the pool, you can see that the audio files are now under file management album song one audio. Now that's one way to move a project with all its contents. The other way is by not using Cubase at all. So let's close this project. Let's get rid of song one under the album directory again. So we can do it some other way. Now the other way is by just moving the whole folder on your hard disk. So now you have album, song one, with the audio files and the Cubase project file right under the song one folder. Now, if you now open this in Cubase, and you go to the pool, you see again that it has recognized that the audio files are now under album song one audio. Okay, I do also want to show you a little variation of that second method, because Cubase will then respond in a slightly different way. So imagine now I'm back to the situation where song one is directly under the Cubase file management, and I have a new folder that I want to copy song one to. For example, I can do copy, go over here, paste, and you now see that there are two song ones. One directly under album and one directly under Cubase file management. Now imagine I wanted to open this song one, which is a new one, which I manually copied. Then Cubase will ask me a question. It says, hey, the project file has been moved. Please confirm the project working directory, under which project folder the audio files will be located. So will it be in the new location? Will I be using the new location's audio files, or will I be using the old location's audio files? Because currently they're still in both places. So if I now say, well, I want to use the new location audio files, it will open the project. And if you look at the pool, it'll be using the audio files under the same album song one folder that contains my Cubase project file. So let's quickly revert the situation again. Let's get rid of the whole album directory, delete, and open the original song one again. Because what do? If you ended up in a situation where you have a project which has audio files all over the place. Let me first create such a project. So over here, I still have my song one project. Let's now import a file and not actually copy it to my new project folder. Let me cut this a bit as well. So now I have a file called summer. If you look in the pool, summer comes from a totally different folder. And if you look on disk, song one audio, there's no summer wave file. So now I have a messed up project. Now obviously it's only one file, so I still might be able to discover it in the pool and then correct it and be done with it. But maybe you've ended up with a project where there's many more files that ended up all over the place. So there is a way in Cubase to repair that. You can basically say media prepare archive. And then Cubase sees that it has external files in the project, which are not in the regular project audio directory. So it says external files will be copied into the working directory. So you can say proceed, pool is ready for archive. And if you now look in the pool, you can see that all files are nicely in Cubase file management song one audio. And also on the disk drive, you can see the summer file was added there and everything is under one directory again. Now, another situation that you may run into with file management, let me save this one, is that you have accidentally moved one of the audio files. So let's move that HomeWave file to outside of the project folder, like right there. So you have your WAV file, and then you have your regular song structure without the HomeWave file in the audio files. So if I now open that project in Cubase, you can see that it complains about missing audio files. So in that case, you can say locate. You can go where the WAV file is. And now it can open your project as usual. And if you look in the pool, your HomeWave file is not under song one audio, but at least it's able to track it again. Of course, you now have the problem that it's not under your main project folder. So again, you can do media prepare archive. External files will be copied. And if you now look at the pool, everything is nicely under the song one audio folder again. Now, another thing which I shortly wanted to show you is how you clean up your pool and your hard drive, basically, because you may have ended up recording lots and lots of files into a project, but not use them anymore. So let's see what happens. If I now remove, for example, this whole home track, and I also remove the summer track. Now Cubase has removed the tracks from the project, but that doesn't mean that the files have been removed. For example, you can see that the files still remain on your hard disk. And if you look in the pool, you can see that the files even still remain in the pool. However, you can see in the pool as well that they are no longer used, the summer and the home file. So if you're now really sure that you don't want to use them anymore and you want to get rid of them, you can go to audio and right click and you can say remove unused media. Now Cubase will ask you, okay, do you want to move them to the trash or do you want to remove them from the pool? But because I intend to clean them up, I say I'm going to move them to the trash. So you see they get removed from the audio folder here and they are moved into the trash. And now on trash you can right click and you can say empty trash. And then Cubase asks again, okay, do you want to remove them from the pool, meaning that they stay on your hard disk? Or do you actually want to remove them from your hard disk as well by choosing the erase option? And that's what I want to do. So I say erase. And if I now look at my hard disk, you see that the summer and HomeWave file have gone in the audio folder and they have been erased. One more smaller thing that I wanted to show you, and that's quite advanced. I'm never using it, but it is possible. So I just want to mention it. Suppose you have like a drum track here. Or maybe a kick. And you have another track here called snare. So they will be used for recording the kick and the snare of a drum set. And maybe you want them recorded in a separate folder so that you have all the drum tracks together, for example. Or because you want to do some separate audio processing on them outside of Cubase, and you want to separate them out in a special folder so you know which files you still want to process. Then it's possible to say set record folder for such a track. And let's say that we still want to keep them under the main project folder, but in a subfolder of audio. New folder, you can call them drums. And if we now start recording on these tracks, Test, test, test. This is a test recording. It's not really drums, but... And if I now go to my pool again, you can see that there's a snare and a kick, and they have been stored directly under audio drums, which is the same as in my folder structure on disk. There's a take two of each one because Cubase has again prepared these zero length files for the next take. Okay, thanks again for watching this video. If you like it or find it useful, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel and ring the little bell icon so you know when I post another video. And if you have any questions about what I just showed you, or maybe you have some nice other ways to handle audio in Cubase that I should know about, then let me know in the comments below. See you soon.